Once upon a time, there was a poor woodcutter who lived in a dilapidated old hut with his beautiful daughter, Emmalora.
Ah, Emmalora, you grow lovelier every day. How could I have been so blessed to have a daughter like you?
Oh, Father, it is I who am blessed to have such a kind and loving father as you.
One day, the woodcutter went into the village to sell his firewood when he met a friend selling milk.
Hello, Farmer Alvin. How goes it?
Fairly good. How's your loving daughter, Emmalora? Have you decided to let me marry her?
She will marry the better of you, my friend.
She is worth her weight in gold. She can even spin straw into gold.
Gold, eh?
I hear this king is interested in gold. 'Tis a golden touch she has.
Long after this, Farmer Alvin took a load of milk to the king.
Okay, here is a golden nugget for your milk.
Ah, gold, I hate to part with it.
Oh, gold. I hear there's a girl in the village who could spin straw into gold.
Spin straw into gold, indeed.
Would I lie to his majesty?
What would be her name?
Emmalora, the poor woodcutter's daughter.
Gods, bring this Emmalora to me. Waste no time.
The guards did as they were told, and Emmalora and her loveliest cape spun from golden flax was brought before the king.
I have learned that you can spin straw into gold, young lady.
Your majesty, I can do...
Enough of this talk. Follow me.
The king led the girl up a winding staircase to the top of the room. There he gestured to a pile of straw filling half of the room, a small only spinning wheel in one corner.
Your majesty, I can...
Enough of this talk. Spin this straw into gold by morning or you will die.
Emmalora sat on the stool, crying helplessly, for she had no idea how to make gold from straw. Suddenly, the door swung open and in came a little man no taller than her knees.
Who are you?
Never mind who I am. What will you give me to spin the straw into gold?
I am but a poor woodcutter's daughter. I have very little, but I will gladly give you my necklace.
The little man took the necklace and set to work at the spinning wheel. By morning, piles of spun gold lay where hours before there was nothing but straw. When the greedy king saw it, he was overjoyed.
Ah, Emmalora, I am indeed pleased. So pleased that I will give you another pile of straw to spin me more gold.
What a creep.
By morning, this will all be spun into gold or you will die.
Fortunately, the king was busy ordering more straw be brought to the small room and didn't hear Amalora's last crack.
Again, Amalora began to weep, and again the door opened and in came the strange little man.
What will you give me this time?
I have this ring my mother gave me before she died.
He sat down and began to spin the straw. By sunrise, the room was again filled with spun straw. And again, the king ordered more straw.
If you spin this straw into gold by morning, I will make you my queen.
Just what I wanted to be. Queen McStingy.
Luckily, the king didn't hear that either. He hurried away just before the little man appeared.
What will you give me this time?
I have nothing left to give you.
Then you will give me our first child when you are queen.
I have no choice, I promise.
The next morning, the straw was gold, and the king married the woodcutter's daughter. A year later, the happy queen had a baby boy and had forgotten all about her promise when Rumpelstiltskin came to claim her baby.
Oh, please, I beg of you, please don't take my baby away from me.
If you can guess my name in 3 days, I will not take your baby boy. But if you cannot guess my name in 3 days, child will be mine.
night, the queen thought of names, hoping one of them would free her from her promise. The next morning, the strange little man appeared, and Emmalora began to try the names.
Is your name John, James, Henry, Ralph, Patrick, James, Henry, Ralph, Snook?
With each name, the little man shook his head no.
Donovan?
None of those is my name.
On the second day, she tried even more names.
Franklin, Trenton, Ralph, Brendan, Patrick, Parker?
No, none of those is my name.
Her father and the woodcutter came with news of a strange sight.
My queen, I was riding through the forest and I caught sight of a fire. I approached and I saw this odd little man dancing around a campfire.
Quickly, what else did you see? What else did you hear?
Well, he danced.
Today I dance, tomorrow I brew. Then, dear prince, I come for you. None can guess and none can claim that Rumpelstiltskin is my name.
That night, the little man came calling. And with that, the little man jumped out the castle window and was never seen again.